tonight I'm out in the Inyo Desert in Southern California, and I'm looking for a few species of scorpions, one including the main target being the Bex Desert Scorpion.
This right here is a Bex Desert Scorpion, Periroctinus becki, and they're quite common out here. The species is part of a complex, so throughout their range they're quite diverse. But anyway, this is what it looks like under white light. And this one's probably a subadult. They don't get too much larger than this. And fun fact, this is the first ever scorpion I was stung by a few years back. Several years back. But anyway, let's let this guy go. Another Bex Desert Scorpion. Little one. This appears to be another Bex Desert Scorpion. Male specimen. Over here is a sand shredder cricket. They actually fluoresce under black light, like this one is now. I'm not entirely sure of the genus, but whatever family they're part of, I believe, or something like that, is the denomination at which all species will fluoresce. And then under white light, that is sort of an ivory color. They're not extremely large. Ah, get back over here. They have all these spines on their feet to be able to dig as well. So right over here, I found our second species of scorpion. It's a little juvenile, and this is Ceratodontis turritus, a saw finger scorpion. There it is right there. Not very large. I'm gonna see if I can find a larger one. But anyway, this species was actually described from this location. This is the type locality, meaning when it was first discovered, that was here. And when they wrote the paper describing the species, they based their description off the specimens from this location. So this right here is actually a fully grown adult female Periroctinus becki. This is how large it is. And yeah, they don't get too much larger than this. For some reason, it's a bit tough to find full-grown adults like this one. So as I'm walking along here, there's actually a little juvenile sidewinder rattlesnake. And this is really as small as you can find them. This is a hatchling, really, a neonate. It was born either this year or last year, more likely this year, during the season. You can see they have those very cool, iconic scales that protrude from above their head. And very few buttons on this one, since it's so young. Another scorpion up here. Don't know what it is entirely until I inspect it. This looks to be another Bex Desert Scorpion. Yeah, it is. This appears to be another Bex Desert Scorpion. They're quite common out here, I guess, but unfortunately haven't found the other scorpions I'm looking for yet, because these guys are dominating. So right here on this wall, a wash wall, there's either an adult or subadult Ceratodontis turritus. I'd say a subadult. I'm gonna poke it out now. I think that's a hole in there, but the piece it's in currently doesn't really go back. Yeah. All right, I'm gonna try to poke it out now. There it is. So this is a subadult. Back on the wall.
This is another Bex desert scorpion hiding under this stick here.
Move that really quickly. And there it is. Another adult, fully grown female. Over here is another Bex desert scorpion. A little juvenile, not very large at all.
Here is another scorpion.
This right here is actually Paravejovis confusus, yellow ground scorpion. Thought I'd see more tonight. Quite a common species, but nice specimen nonetheless. This is an adult female. This is a little juvenile Bex desert scorpion again. And over here, not too far away, is another one. The density on the species out here is pretty good. Under here in this bush is another Bex desert scorpion. Not entirely sure where it went. Oh, there it is. Medium-sized individual.
Over here is another scorpion.
Oh, this is the only Hadrurus I've seen all night. This is a desert hairy scorpion. Hadrurus arizonensis. A very small one at that. This is the largest species of scorpion out here, but of course this one is not matured yet. They get as big as like half of an adult human's hand. Little juvenile scorpion here, which I suspect to be another turritus. And it is not very easy to see, but I won't take it out. So right here on this rock hut is probably the largest ceratodontidus turritus that I've ever seen. Try to get it off here. There it is. A very nice specimen indeed. Somewhere over here, there was a second scorpion. Ah, there it is. There's a scorpion in the crack up here. Hanging out. And I think that's also a turritus. I'll try to get it off camera. I managed to get the second scorpion out of that crack. And here's the other one that I just showed you. Here are both of the turritus, and like I said, this is as large as they get. I've never seen any specimens as large as this, and quite surprised to see two of them only a couple meters away. I'm now going to release these back where I found them. There's one and second one. There's a scorpion over here on this wall, rock wall. It appears to be another turritus. There it is. About the same size as the other ones I found not too long ago. Very cool. Let it go. Another one of these sand shredder crickets fluorescing under UV light. Cool thing about these is that they're omnivores. They'll actively hunt things, also scavenge, but mostly eat grains and whatnot. another medium-sized Periarctinus becky in here.
Over here is an adult Hydrurus arizonensis,
to show you just how large they are. Here's my hand next to it. Very large scorpion.
And they only get a bit larger than this one, and that would be pushing it. This is quite a large specimen. Quite light too. Almost looks like a pallid hairy scorpion, which was a former subspecies of this species, H.A. pallidus. Well, I'm gonna release this specimen now, so it can go back to eating things like small lizards and small snakes. They've been observed eating rattlesnakes even. May have been speckled rattlesnakes or sidewinders, I forget. All right, back you go. Found this little scorpion under my tent in the morning when packing up. I think this is another turritus. This is the type of habitat I was in last night. Sort of a conjunction of different environments. Anyway, that's the end of the video, so thanks for watching.